You know, in prison, a lot of tattoo men make a lot of money. A lot of them also get theyself in a lot of shit. Don't be like one of them.
Hold down, man, suitcase this. My cell phone and my charger don't walk with a limp. Get it knocked off or missing, you gon' get it. Next time I see you, you gon' leave airlifted.
What's up, everybody? You already know, man. Kid Frog TV back in the building. Y'all do me that solid favor. Go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button. And make sure you hit the notification bell so you can see it first. Today, I'm gonna be speaking on an incident that happened while I was locked up in the Florida State Prison. Y'all sit back and enjoy and pray that you never have to go there. Today, I'm gonna be speaking about tattoo men, which y'all know I did a video back in the day speaking on them, you know, but I'm gonna be speaking on this situation that occurred with this one specific tattoo man while I was incarcerated, okay? Anyone who does tattoos or has been locked up knows that there is a lot of money behind tattoo men, you know? That is an awesome hustle. Everyone wants to get tatted. You know, everyone wants to come home with fresh ink. You know, it's kind of like a, you know, it's kind of like a war wound. You know, you mark yourself with it. You feel me? And you always remember where you got it. You understand? You know how they say you never want to get a tattoo unless it really means something. Well, when you're incarcerated and you get tattoos, you know, you're basically down at your worst, you know? It's a reminder of where you once were and what you had to go through. If you're succeeding in life 10 years from now, you will look down at the ink that you got put on you and you will remember where you was when you got that. You understand? Now, I'm gonna be speaking on this one dude, you know, y'all already know what his nickname was, Tattoo. Every camp I've been to, there's been a couple dudes named Tattoo. You feel me? Nah, just call me Tattoo. That's what every 9 out of 10 tattoo men, you know, tell you to call them. Feel me? I've had a couple other ones, you know, that weren't called that. But this one here, his nickname was Tattoo. Everyone you come across claims they're the best artist, claims that they do a cheaper price than anyone else, claims that they can do it faster than someone else can, all that. Well, this tattoo artist I'm speaking on, he, you know, he really knew his shit. He was really raw. He was talented, all right? You come across some talented people while you're locked up, whether it's some real ass artists that are real good at rapping or singing or people that know how to draw portraits or whatever it may be. You know, you come across some real talented people behind the walls. Well, him, he was real talented. And especially for, you know, making a tattoo gun out of the motor that's inside of an electric shaver. You feel me? You know, using that and making the little tattoo machine and making soot, which is actually freshly made ink, whether it's made out of Maori's hair grease or sardine oil or lard out of the kitchen, no matter what it is. He was real raw, you know, for the little things that he had access to. But I'm going to tell you about Tattoo. Tattoo was the type of person. If you went up to him and you started talking about a type of tattoo you wanted, he'd literally be like, when you want to do it. And you could be like, whenever you have an opening. Okay, you got my money? You feel me? And then he'd be like, yeah, I could get it when they call canteen. Okay, we'll do it after we hit canteen then. And he would literally start knocking people out with their tattoos like clockwork. You know, he didn't give a damn where we were. You could be on the rec yard. Feel me? And he'd try to find a blind spot on the rec yard tattooing someone. That's just how he was. He'll go to your dorm. You could be in an open bay or a two-man cell. He would go to your dorm and slang ink on you. You feel me? And that's the type of person he was. But the one thing that you never, ever want to do when you're a tattoo man is make someone pay you up front and then you not pull forward and you not, you know, bring the, you know, the ink, bring the tattoo piece like you're supposed to do. So what happened with Tattoo was no matter what camp he went to, he was always known for slanging ink. He's had so many tattooing DRs, so many possessions of contraband stuff. They found so many different things of ink, you know, found needles, all types of shit. He was in prison for probably like 8 years around the time I met him. And, you know, he was a cool dude, but the only down thing with him is he liked to get high. All right, he was in there smoking K2. You feel me? Tunchi, you know? And anyone knows, boy, that Tunchi's no joke. That's literally the devil on your shoulder trying to shake that shit, kind of like heroin. They literally have bodies when it comes to that K2 shit, you feel me? So K2, you know, it overpowered, you know, Tattoo. He would fuck around and he would make someone pay him so he can get high. And then, you know, for a while he was able to stick with the pattern of, I got you, bro, I got you. And he would make the schedule, you know what I'm saying? Well, on this occasion, you feel me, he wasn't able to, you know, present what he needed to present. So he found himself in a messed up situation. He went around and started asking people to borrow money so he could pay someone back that paid him already in advance for a tattoo. You feel me? But all that's doing is meaning you're owing more people now. You see? But the person who he owed a tattoo to was literally pushing that issue. Caught him slipping one time, walking around by the chow hall, and they busted him with a lock. You feel me? Didn't make him check in. You know, didn't none of that shit. They wanted their money. So they were literally roughing him up for that money. Hit him with a lock on one occasion. You feel me? And this was like months at a time. Like, you know, like they literally picked on Tattoo for a while. You know, and some other people stood up and, you know, defended Tattoo because if he's such a good tattoo artist, a lot of people are going to stand up like, man, you got my tattoo man fucked up. You know what I'm saying? And people are going to put their neck on the line behind a person that's slanging ink that good. You feel me? So, and if it's a small tab, some people even cover that shit, man. You leave the fuck alone. And then they'll go tell the tattoo man, look, bro, I got that done. Now, when you find the time, bro, I want a piece right here. You feel me? I covered that tab for you. I got them off your ass. Now, I need a piece right here. You feel me? And then normally the tattoo man will be cool with it. Well, on this occasion here, he was borrowing from other people who weren't going to take the fade for him, who weren't going to stand up and protect him or nothing like that. And he didn't really tell them that he was going to, you know, basically use their money to, you know, pay that tab. He just made it seem like, you feel me, hey, bro, you know, I'll put you in line for a tattoo if you want to pay up front. And he was just owing more people his time. And in prison, boy, you never know, dog. You feel me? We can get put on lockdown. They can do a shakedown, you know, control movement. You never know what it is. So if you promise someone you're going to tat them today, bro, you might not be able to tat them. You get what I'm saying? And then something occur and pop up. Now we on lockdown for 3 days. Well, when you get off lockdown for 3 days, the same people who you were supposed to tattoo 3 days from now feel like they're supposed to be next in line and it's their turn because it's been 3 days. They're not thinking about the person that had to wait because of the 3 day lockdown. You see what I'm saying? So anyways, Tattoo, you know, he decided, you know, he was going to try to go out with a bang. And what I mean by that is he decided the same person who he owed money to, he decided to catch him slipping. You feel me? He thought that he was going to make the dude check in. He thought if he applied enough pressure one time, he was tired of the person picking on him. He's got these other dudes coming after him for money now because he borrowed from them just to pay this dude. But that dude, like, just didn't like Tattoo. You feel me? Because from my perspective and what I seen Tattoo drop off canteen to that dude a couple times. You know what I'm saying? Dude slid to the dorm a couple times also, and Tattoo handed over some shit. So I'm thinking, like, how much money did Tattoo charge this guy for this damn tattoo is what it looked like, you know? But then again, if it was someone that was extorting Tattoo and was like putting down on him, just making him pay rent or break it off, then I'm pretty sure someone would have stood up and been like, hey, bro, hell nah, bro. It ain't going down like that. But since Tattoo did front the money from the dude, people just left Tattoo in that water. Like, bro, we can't, you feel me, defend you, dog, because he's right. All he's trying to do is collect the money that you owe him. You get what I'm saying? So anyways, Tattoo decided to catch the man slipping. And what he did is, the dude had a call out in medical, you know. Call out is where they put a packet on the inside the day room, or they put it on the wall, whatever dorm you're in, and it's going to show where everyone's got to be at, what time they have to be there, if you got to be somewhere, whether it's education, kitchen, chapel, classification, you know, wherever it may be, medical, it's going to all show that on there. So he happened to be looking at it. You know, it's your responsibility to look at the call out, because if your ass ain't there, you're going to get a 15-day DR for being in an unauthorized area, because you ain't supposed to be in your dorm right now. You're supposed to be at classification. Feel me? But it shows everyone's names and stuff like that, DC numbers. You feel me? Shows what dorm they're in and shit like that. So if you ever want to look for someone that you got a hit on or anything like that, it's easy to see that on there. So he happened to be looking through that shit one night. He was sitting there just chilling, and he happened to be looking through it to see if he had a call out in the morning, because it's mandatory that you don't look through it. Your ass don't want to land in the box for nothing. You feel me? So as he was looking through the call out, I guess he seen that the other dude had a call out at medical early in the morning. So he was like, all right, you know what? Fuck it. Didn't tell nobody what he was doing or nothing. He decided to walk up to the dude, you feel me, and take off on him. You feel me? He thought he was just going to whoop him. No weapons, no nothing. And I didn't actually see it go down when he took off on him in front of medical, you feel me? Because like I said, I lived in the dorm with him, but I didn't follow him, you understand? I didn't know what he was going to do. None of us did. Anyways, he took off on the dude in front of medical. When he took off in front of the dude in medical, you feel me? No one went to confinement, not the dude he took off on or him. They didn't get in trouble or nothing like that, which to me, I felt like is a big no-no. because someone can't live here no more now that the tension done turned up. You feel me? So when Tattoo came back to the dorm, you feel me? He came up to my bunk and he was trying to, you know, front some cigarettes off me. He's like, bro, I promise I'll pay you, bro, this and that, this and that. And then he gave me the whole little rundown of the situation that occurred in front of medical. I'm like, bro, you played Tattoo, you feel me? He was like, man, nah, dog, but you know, at the same time, bro, he been trying me, bro, for months, bro. He been putting that pressure on me, this and that, this and that. I said, yeah, dog, but you supposed to get that boy from around here. Like, there's no way you could just flop like that. You feel me? We call that flopping. You can't just do that to that man and think that shit gonna be sweet. Because now, he's still out there, bro. That boy's in his dorm right now waiting to come get your ass in the morning. Literally, that's what it's gonna occur to, you feel me? And he was just so like, man, I need to smoke a cigarette, bro. I need to get this pressure off, bro. I mean, you know, this, that. And I could tell, you know, he was literally stressing. You know, he was nervous. He was scared. He was worried. So what did I do? I said, here, bro, go ahead. Here's a dollar holler, bro. Go ahead, bro. Smoke your cigarette. Do what you got to do. And he's sitting there. He rolls it up. He's smoking it. And he's like shaking, bro. He's nervous, dog. He probably never did no shit like that in his life, dog. But something, you never know what's going on in someone's head and what people got on their chest and shoulders that makes them react the way he reacted. You feel me? Sure enough, dog. So I go up to him and I'm like, bro. So I'm like, what you finna do about it, bro, tomorrow, bro? When he come in his dorm, you know he gonna come in here. He like, man, he come in here, dog. I'm gonna try to kill him. I said, for real? He's like, I'm gonna kill him, bro. I said, nah. He's like, man, I put that shit on everything I love, bro. I put that on my kids, bro. I put that on my old girl, bro. I put that on this. He starts telling me all the different shit. I'm like, for real? He like, yeah. I'm like, damn, that real? Nah, you feel me? I mean, shit, it is what it is. You hear people saying shit like that, people actually trying to do it and doing it every day in prison. So I didn't think nothing of it. So I'm like, okay, you finna bag that boy. Fuck it. You know what I'm saying? You better get him before he gets you. Next thing you know, I go lay my ass down. He's still over there smoking in the corner. I wake up early in the morning. They hit the lights for breakfast. I look over. Tattoo's whole bunk is gone. Empty. Out of there. Pure blank. Mattress is folded in half. Ain't a sheet over there. Ain't no towels, no shoes, no slides, no nothing. His locker's wide open. And Tattoo checked in, man. And I'm like, damn, bro. Like, he pulled all that gorilla gangster shit. You feel me? And look, I gave him that dollar holler on the house. Like, go ahead, bro. He would have fronted it off me, bro, and still checked in. You see what I'm saying? Couldn't take that pressure, dog. That's what happens with a lot of people. Not just Tattoo Man, dog. A lot of people, bro, they front. Before they know it, bro, it's a wrap, dog. They can't, they got too many fucking needs and not enough sources of income to supply it all, bro. You feel me? Tattoo checked in, dog. I couldn't believe it, man. And next thing you know, I'm like, damn, bro, fucking Tattoo's out of here, dog. I was telling my homeboy while we was in there brushing our mouth early in the morning. We were brushing our teeth. And I was like, man, fucking Tattoo, dog. He's like, yeah, this and that, this and that. And you best believe the same dude he swung on came to our dorm looking for him right around breakfast time. As soon as they popped the door for breakfast, here he comes sliding in there clutching with a knife. And he looked over. Buddy, shit was gone. But the crazy thing about it is, I ran into Tattoo again. You feel me? When I ended up leaving Charlotte CI, okay, I got transferred from Charlotte probably fucking, I say, maybe a year and a half after this Tattoo incident. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I got 200 something days in confinement for K-Frog TV. You feel me? And once I got shipped, I went through confinement in South Florida Reception Center, stayed there for about a week, and then they brought me to DeSoto Annex. Once I got the DeSoto Annex, I run into the Tattoo. Same person. I was like, man, you checked in on scary ass, you feel me? I ain't really have no rap for him at first, you know? I don't really talk to people like that, you feel me? When they fluke out like that, I don't really talk to them. But I was short-timing in. I only had like 70 days left, so you feel me? I decided I'd make a joke out of it, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, boy, Tattoo, old scary ass. Boy, I caught up with you. What my money you owe me? Just joking, you feel me? And he looks over and he's like, K-Frog, what's up, bro? I'm like, shit, bro. I'm saying, what my money you owe me? He like, bro, I owe you money. You feel me? He started thinking, I owe you no money. He's like, bro, that dollar holler was free. Like, he already, you feel me? So I was like, nah, I'm just fucking with y'all. See your scary ass check in over there. He like, bro, they were finna kill me, bro. I had to get from around there, bro. I'm like, man, that's crazy as fuck, bro. I'm like, bro, you put that shit on your kid, your old girl, all this shit. He like, bro, what I was supposed to do, dog? He was like, bro, that was the scariest thing I've ever went through in prison, bro. I said, for real? He's like, yeah, bro. He's like, man, I've been making a killing, bro. Once I got shit from there, bro, I started making a killing, bro. I said, what, you slanging ink over here, still smoking Tunchi and shit? He like, yeah, I still be smoking, but I don't be fronting from people no more. I'm like, man. I'm like, dog, you still shouldn't have did that sucker shit, though, dog. You should have went out with a bang, you feel me? And he was like, man, you know what I'm saying, bro? I thought about it, bro. He's like, I stayed up that whole night, dog. And then I said, man, I'm going to leave for his safety. I'm like, yeah, that shit sound good. He like, dog, he's like, you think that was a big enough pride issue? You think it was hard enough? It was so hard for me to check in like that, bro? Bro, you should have seen what the hard part was. And I'm like, what was that? He's like, bro, I had to take my machine with me. I'm like, oh, you talking about your tattoo gun? He like, yeah, bro. I'm like, how you do that? He's like, what you mean, bro? I had to boof it. I said, you boofed your tattoo machine? He's like, yeah, bro, I had to boof that shit, bro. That's my moneymaker right there. They go for like $100 at each place, bro. I couldn't start off $100 back. I said, that's crazy, dog. He's like, what do you mean, bro? I still got it, bro. It's the same one I'm slanging ink over there in G-Dorm. I said, for real? He's like, yeah, bro, I've been boofing that shit, bro, from institution to institution. I'm like, oh, man, that's crazy. He's like, bro, it is what it is, bro. That's my bread and butter. That's what he kept saying. It's my bread and butter, bro. That's how I eat, bro. That's my bread and butter. I'm like, that's crazy, bro. So not only did that boy check in, bro, but he boofed his tattoo gun. His tattoo machine, you feel me? For those that don't really know what the tattoo machine looks like, this one homemade one right here. This is just the machine right here. This is the motor, which that right there is from inside of a, you know, an electric shaver. You get what I'm saying? Even though it ain't that big of a piece or whatever, but still, bro, that boy boofed that shit. You know what I'm saying? And it's crazy, though, because me running back into him and him telling me all that shit, and he was just so excited he was still alive. You know, I'm like, man, I couldn't be mad at him. Like, even if he would have got me for the dollar, I just would have been like, well, bitch, you finna hit this window right now and either get me a bag of Doritos, a bag of Cheetos, a Sprite, a Coke, or something, bro. You feel me? Finna pay that tab right now. And I would have sat there and laughed at his ass about checking in while I drank the soda or ate my chips. You feel me? But it was the fact that he was so happy that he didn't get killed at Charlotte, man. Because people were getting busted up, dog, getting fucked up at Charlotte CI, dog. And I tell this shit all the time, bro. Y'all can look that mortality sheet up if you want to. All you gotta do is Google it. Charlotte CI mortality sheet. And you'll see a lot of them, they ain't really putting what it really is. They'll put natural causes, accident, you know, and under investigation, pending, you know. A lot of that shit ain't really what they say it is, you feel me? I was there, take it from me, you know. But like I said, man, if you a tattoo man and you good at slanging ink, bro, when you go to prison, bro, so many people are going to want you to tat them. So many people are going to try to put money in your pocket. So many people are going to like your work and your skills that they're going to want to give you the money up front. And, bro, if you can't keep up with that shit and you can't keep your word, do not accept that money first, okay? Because when this fucking dude tattooed, I'm talking about he was a cool-ass person, bro. That dude wasn't sparing him no matter how cool he was. And he got off light, dog, compared to what I seen happen with a bunch of other people. He literally got off light. This is just a funny story right here. This ain't no serious nitty-gritty-ass savage shit that I done seen happen to tattoo men. You feel me? But I just wanted to tell y'all a story about this one because it just blew my mind. I ran into his ass over a year and a half later, and here he was with the same tattoo gun slanging ink at that pound, and he didn't go straight to DeSoto from Charlotte. He went to like one or two other camps after that. So here he is three camps after where we were at, and he still got that tattoo gun, bragging how he boofed that bitch from institution to institution. You feel me? And I'm like, oh, man. But, you know, at the same time, he had to hustle, dog. He did what he had to do. That shit ain't for me, boy. Ain't nothing going against the grain. You get what I'm saying? On my end, I'll get caught with that bitch and go to confinement and lay down before I do some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? But it just shows, dog. You get yourself in some situations, bro. You're going to run across some people, dog, in there that are going to do some shit that would never cross your mind yourself. You feel me? You're going to come across people that are going to, they're all in by any means, bro. They rather damage their body and do shit to they self harmfully than to get caught with it. You feel me? Man, that shit just mind-blowing. And I'm speaking for Florida prison. You know, I don't know how it is anywhere else. I only been locked up in the state of Florida. You get what I'm saying? And that shit's just mind-blowing, dog. But I hope Tattoo, you feel me? I hope he's doing all right, wherever the hell he's at. You feel me? He probably done got fucked up on Tunchi again and started owing more people money. You never know, dog. Because people that do bids like that, they got a harder and a longer bid ahead of them. You feel me? If you're a tattoo man and you just go in there and you just get paid after you slang the ink, or you get half up front and then half after, you know what I'm saying? Or however it is, you know, you might be worried they're going to run off on you after you do the tattoo, so you want the money up first. I get that. Well, how about you get the money the day you're going to do the tattooing? That's my best advice to you. You give me, okay, how much? 75 for the whole sleeve? Okay, boom. Bring the 75 to my, the day you want to get tatted. Okay, boom. Yeah, I got a scale. Yeah, go get it right here. Here's my list. This is what I want. Go get it. When you come back in, we'll get tatted. Do it just like that. You feel me? So that way you ain't got to worry about that, bro. Because there's people in there getting bagged and slumped over some petty ass shit. You feel me? But anyways, man, I just want to share this story with y'all and tell you all the time the tattoo man checked in and he decided to boof his fucking tattoo machine. That shit just mind-blowing, dog. And to make it through institutions like that, dog, to know he had the same tattoo gun, in my mind, I'm like, bro, that shit's just crazy, dog. You feel me? And he was like, bro, I'll slay ink on you for free, bro, because you feel me, dog? We go way back, bro. I'll slay ink on you. And I'm like, bro, I'm good, bro. I ain't trying to get no tattoos over here. I don't want no DRs right here at DeSoto, bitch. I'm trying to go home. You feel me? Bitch, I'm on a countdown. It's my first time having less than 100 days, bitch. I'm gonna lay down, bro, and take my ass to the highs, finally. And that's what I did, y'all. But anyways, man, I'm gonna wrap this video on up. I appreciate y'all watching it. Y'all let me know in the comment section, man, if you've ever went through anything like this. If you seen someone boof that shit when they checked in, or if you know people boofing it, or if you know a place where they think boofing's cool and allowed. Because I done heard some stories about some different, you know, different places where, you know, that shit's like mandatory type shit. You feel me? But not down here in the state of Florida. But anyways, man, like I said, man, I'm gonna wrap this one on up. Appreciate y'all watching. Keep them snakes, rats, squares, and clowns out your circle. Until next time, you already know, man, this frog.